息がくせえよ、豚野郎。
For years, we wondered, speculated, and theorized about what could possibly turn Kawaki into the person we saw during the flash forward.
I'm going to send you to the same place I sent the 7th Hokage, Boruto.
There are clues hidden throughout the manga, but more specifically in Boruto Chapter 58. Welcome back, dreamers. Kawaki is a character who's driven by fear. Fear is at the heart of nearly every choice that he's made in the past and will make in the future.
延々と続く地獄のような日々の中で生きた心地なんてしなかった。
Kawaki has been abused his entire life. All he knows is pain and suffering.
俺に触るな！
He suffered at the hands of his father, who sold him to a man who physically and mentally abused him as well. So when the opportunity presented itself, he ran. A decision born from fear. This would lead to him being captured by Konoha and placed under the direct supervision of the 7th Hokage, Naruto Uzumaki.
ここは安全な場所だ。何も心配することはね。
However, something strange would happen. Naruto wasn't a tyrant who abused him, but instead showed him love and empathy. Naruto gave him a home, a family. For the first time in his life, Kawaki felt the warmth of a father. For Kawaki, Naruto became a symbol, something irreplaceable, someone precious to be protected at all costs. But because of his presence in Konoha, Ishiki attacked Naruto, and because of this attack, Kurama died. Naruto lost the power to defend himself. The symbol is more vulnerable than ever.
そもそもの原因は俺だからな。俺がいるからカラに襲われた。守ってくれたのはあんたの方だ。
To Kawaki, this was his fault. So he takes responsibility. He makes a decision born from the fear of losing his newfound family. He will protect Naruto, but in order to do that, he must have power. I believe Kawaki is developing an unhealthy obsession with power. The power to protect. He blames himself for what happened to Naruto specifically and wants to take responsibility. Much like Sasuke, who became obsessed with gaining power to achieve his goals, Kawaki is walking down a similar path. Not the path of the Avenger, but rather the path of the Protector. And although that may seem like a noble and righteous path to walk, obsessing over anything, even a good thing, can be extremely unhealthy. I believe the fear of losing his newfound family will cause Kawaki to develop an obsession with gaining the power to protect them. And through his desire to protect, he will make choices that will lead him down a dark path. We see in Boruto Chapter 58 that Kawaki views traditional shinobi training as inefficient. This is an important point because it illustrates his disconnect with shinobi culture and traditions. In Boruto Chapter 58, there is a scene where Kawaki attempts to use his karma in order to absorb an attack from Boruto. Even though he no longer possesses one, despite his disgust for the karma seal and everything it represents, Kawaki still views it as pure power, which is what he desperately desires. I believe Kawaki will attempt to regain karma's power and advance through technological means instead of traditional shinobi means. This decision will be in direct opposition to Boruto's beliefs, resulting in an ideological clash. I believe Kawaki will want to gain power by any means and protect his new family by any means, even if the power he gains destroys him or the means in which he protects his family goes against what they desire. In chapter 58, we also see that Kawaki doesn't work well with others. I believe that he will put everything on himself. He will become a dictator in a sense, ignoring the advice and perspectives of everyone around him. It's not what you do, it's how you go about doing it. His intentions will start out good, but over time, I believe he will impose his will onto others, removing their agency, their ability to freely choose. The fight we saw in chapter 58 is foreshadowing the method in which Kawaki will attempt to achieve his goals. Not through traditional means that he believes are inefficient. Not through a democratic process where everyone voices opinions he doesn't value. No. My way of gaining power is the most efficient way. Not yours. My methods for protecting everyone are better than yours. Sitting here, listening to all these different perspectives is a waste of time. My way is the best way, and whether you want to or not, you will do it my way, because it's for your own good. You might not like my methods, hell, you might not like me, but at least you'll be safe in the end. And as long as you're safe, I can justify the methods that I use to keep you safe. This is what I believe Kawaki's mindset will be. The mindset that will lead him down a dark path. You take a boy who has never known love nor peace, a boy who has never had a home, who was abused his whole life, and you show him love, you give him warmth, you show him what it means to be a part of a family, and then you threaten to take it all away from him. Love means so much more to a person who has only known hate their entire life. That boy would do anything to stop that from happening. Cross every line, go to every extreme. Kawaki's love will consume him and everyone around him.